Carpentry Addict. I am Domingo Freire and you are again in your favorite DIY channel. Today I will talk you about this amazing tool, my WORKPRO Cordless Chainsaw. When you acquire the WORKPRO Chainsaw, it will come with this case and the following accessories. It brings us two spare saw chains to change them when the one it has installed no longer cuts well. This tool comes with another guide bar for the saw change like the one you see here, and comes with a cover to store the tool and avoid cutting ourselves when we are not using the saw. It comes with the charger with two 12-volt batteries, and also includes a container for when we need to grease the passage of the saw change in the future. The first thing when handling this tool is to remember safety. So while you are not going to use it, I recommend handling it without having the battery connected. This way you will avoid accidents. Our tool is powered by this 12-volt battery that we will place in the end of the grip when we are going to use it. This tool is very simple, and the first thing we have to know is that it turns on when we press the trigger that we see on the grip handle. For safety, the tool will only turn on if before pulling the trigger we press the unlock button that we have here. It's also important to know where to hold the tool if you need to use both hands when making a cut. For that, here we have the secondary grip that allows us to make this type of cuts with precision and safety. Here we have the chain on its guide bar, and this icon tells us the direction the chain turns when turning on the saw. This support piece helps us making the cut, keeping what we are cutting stationary. For safety, up here we have the chain guard that prevents any object from touching the saw at the top while we cut any branch or trunk. In this part, we can see two screws that allows us to make adjustments to the chain. The first is this bigger one, with which we can open the tool to change the saw chain or the bar on which the chain moves. This smaller adjusting screw is what we use to adjust the chain tension if necessary. Now we are going to place the battery, so that when we turn it on, we can see these LED lights that indicate the battery charge level. You can see that the green light indicates that the battery is fully charged, and when it changes to yellow or red, it will indicate that the charge level has dropped. I'm going to make this test cut on this 2x1 inch piece of wood. To make the cut correctly and safely, we must hold the saw well. For that, I remind you that above the tool, we have the secondary grip that makes easier for us to have good control when making the cut. It is also important to know that the saw rotates in this direction, and this is the support piece of our tool to make the cut, keeping the piece of wood to be cut immobile. We must avoid making cuts with the tip of the saw. The correct thing is to use the support piece to proceed with cutting. Of course, it's very important to never have our leg in the direction of the saw's cutting motion. Lastly, as with any saw, we never stick it to the wood to turn it on. We must always turn on the saw, and when it's spinning at maximum speed, we bring it closer to the piece that we are going to cut. Here you can see the cut I made in a dry palm tree in my garden. This dry palm tree trunk is about 5 inches in diameter, and you can see how easy this saw makes the cut. This tool is really light, has a lot of power, and will make your gardening work easier. That's why I recommend the WORKPRO Mini Chain Saw. Now you can cut any branch in your garden using this saw. Remember to click on like, share, and comment this video. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will see you in my next video.